Yesper sent me their X1 jump starter or air compressor. So I'm going to just do a quick unboxing right now and then show you where this can be useful in your life. The battery capacity is 12,000 milliamp hours or 44.4 watt hours. And you can see that the output can vary between 12 volts and 5 volts depending on what you're doing. And then it has input chargeability of 5 volt 2 amps, takes 3.5 hours to charge. Peak current is 2000 amps, and that's how it's able to jumpstart a regular car, replacing its 12 volt battery. On the inside of the box, it has a user manual, and then this is the main device itself. And here is what that looks like. To turn on the device, I can press and hold the power button here. It shows me the display there of how many PSI it is right now. And if I wanted to turn on the air pump, which you can see there's a hole there for it, I can press this power button. And that turns on. Now here in the box, it has some of the other accessories that come along with it. So this is the jump starter cables here for your battery. And then this is your nozzle for the air pump. So this screws into the top right there into that port. And then here is the Schrader valve, of course, that goes onto like a bicycle tire stem or something else for a tire. And then it comes with a USB-A to USB-C cable for charging it. And then this right here being the jump starter cables, you can see there's a port right here on the side of the device. So I can pop that open. And this is a, it looks like a proprietary port that I can plug this in. And that pops out the side just like that. And now I can use these alligator clamps to clamp onto a battery terminals, and basically it will supply the 12 volts needed and up to 2000 amps to start a car or do whatever else you need. The other ports here on top, you can see it has the input port for charging the battery. It has a light, and then it has an output port, 5 volts, 2.1 amps. So you could use this to charge devices. To turn on the light, I press this button right there, and you see the light turns on. And each time I push that button, it goes into a different flashing mode. So faster, slower, and then off. And then here it has a mode button that alternates between different levels of PSI just to get you there more quickly, I guess, to that category. And then it has a plus or minus button here to go up and down in PSI. So pretty basic there on the pump, but that's really all you need. And lastly, here in the box, it does come with 3 adapters in that bag. So it comes with a Presta to Schrader valve adapter, which is very handy. And then it comes with a needle for filling, you know, balls, fill like a beach ball or something to that effect. So now that I've shown you this, let's go test it out. So one of the primary use cases that I wanted to try this with is jumpstarting a Tesla, since obviously I work with Teslas all the time on my channel. And this is a legitimate potential problem that happens with Teslas. Just to be clear, Teslas have a high voltage battery pack, which is hundreds of batteries in parallel and series that drive the car down the road. That's not the battery we're talking about. We're talking about the low voltage battery, which is meant for powering all of the accessories of the car, the door actuators, the windows, and all of that. So when the car is turned off and you walk away from it, it has a contactor that it disconnects from the high voltage battery. And that means that the low voltage battery, which has very small energy storage capacity, is now in charge of running things. And periodically, if the voltage on that battery gets low enough, then the vehicle will detect that it needs to be powered back up. And it will power the high voltage contactor to re-engage with the high voltage battery, and it'll charge up the low voltage battery. The problem comes into play sometimes where when the lifespan is being reached with that low voltage battery, it doesn't have enough voltage to power the actuator, or the contactor rather, that then, you know, charges it back up from the high voltage battery. And so then the battery just kind of dies. And then when you try to get into the car, nothing works and you can't even get into the car because that low voltage battery is what powers those actuators. So what we have right here is my friend's car, Grant. He's holding the camera. And we're in the parking lot of this Lowe's. He went in, he was shopping, and came back out, and his low voltage battery appears to have died. So basically, it won't work. So as an example, he has his cell phone in his pocket, and if I try to open the door right here, nothing's happening. If we try to unlock the car right here, it's not detecting it. So you might wonder, like, well, how do you get into your car in this situation? Now, I've never done this before, so this is my first time testing this in the real world, you know, the car that actually is off. So what you do, this right here is a little circle door that is for the tow point. You have there's a hook inside that you can screw into a hole here. So to open this, you push pressure at about 2 or 3 o'clock right here, and there is a pivot point. So if you push right there, and trying to do it gently, pry it from there, there it goes. Then you pull back, and you can see that that's the pivot point I'm talking about. There's a point there and a point there. and then these are those two points, and then it's kind of like latched onto the back right here. So when you pull this out, if you look down in there straight away in there, you can see that there's a hole, and that is for the tow point. If you were to pull this vehicle up onto the tow truck, like a flatbed tow truck, for instance, this is what you would use to do that. But additionally, what is right here is these two wires basically. And what these are used for is it powers the actuator for this trunk, or the hood, the frunk latching mechanism right here. Now what I have is in my hand, this is a 12 volt battery. It's a tiny little battery that has 12 volts in this one cell. And so what I did on my car is I took one of these batteries, wrapped it in a Ziploc bag, and then zip tied it right here so that it's in the location where I need it in the future. So what you can do with this is you can see these wires, the one's black and one's red. So black is negative, and with this battery, you can see here it says positive, and over here is negative. I'm holding the bottom part of the battery, the negative terminal, to here, and then holding the positive up here and touching that. That does not seem to be working. So it might be that my 12 volt battery is bad. I have switched over here to my car now, and I just wanted to show how I have my 12 volt battery in here. So I'm gonna pop this little door out of the way, and you can see the 12 volt battery is right here, zip tied or twisty tied in a Ziploc bag to keep it dry right there. So I'm gonna take this out and see if it actually works, because the other one that I tried didn't. And so I just wanna see if it was a problem with just that other battery, or if all of them don't work for this purpose. All right, so I've taken the battery out of the plastic bag, and let's try it in this case. So I'm gonna put the negative side on the negative end of the battery, and then this red wire on the positive side of the battery, and let's see if it works. Ah, yes, it does. So just to quick demonstrate that these batteries can go bad apparently. My other one wasn't working, this one is. Luckily, this is the one that I had on my car, but the one that I was using earlier in that video was apparently a bad one, so I'll toss that one. Let's just move on to using the main event, which is the jump pack here. Plug in the negative here, and then the positive here. And then on this jump pack, there's this boost button right here. So I pressed boost, or hold it, and you can see it popped the frunk just like that. So basically what that's doing is it didn't detect any electricity already at these wires, and so it didn't do anything it didn't send electricity as a safety mechanism, but by pressing boost, it tells it, you know what, send electricity right now. And so it did just that. So now with these wires, we're done with this. So you can go ahead and, you know, put this cover back on and put this back together. So this is a 2021 Tesla Model Y, and the low voltage battery on this is a lead acid battery. It's 12 volts. It's more the traditional voltage that this jump pack was designed for. So I'm confident that this will work. In later years, the newer Teslas, they have a lithium ion battery that is now 16 volt nominal. And I think their voltage range is somewhere around 15.5 to 15.8 volts or something like that from what I've heard. So this jump pack voltage is lower than that. And so I'm not sure if it will work or not. I haven't tested that. So for this car though, what we need to do now is just pop up this cover. There's a couple of clips across the top and the sides. So you wanna kind of pull straight up, and then those clips will pop out pretty simply. You don't need tools for this. There you go, hold that down. I'm just gonna put that on the ground over here. So what that exposes is the low voltage 12 volt battery right here. And so you can see there's a negative battery terminal indicator right here, and then the positive is right there. So what we can do is take our jump pack, put on the negative there and the positive. On the boost, there's a light here that says correct and then reverse, and it shows that it's correctly connected. So now that that is on, I'm going to press this boost button right here. And I don't see anything happening. I'm gonna go try the key card. Oh, you can hear things happening?
Yeah.
So we put this here. Look at that, it's working, yeah. And my understanding is that this should basically, this jump pack is replacing the battery of, you know, the functionality that is this main battery powering the car. So at least we're able to get into it, but it should also allow the computer systems to power up. And that has not yet, oh, there it is. There's the Tesla T logo. And then also the air is starting to blow out of the vents right now. So that's a good sign. So what I want to do is once this comes up, there we go, I can now press the brake, and the car has just gone into the drive mode. And now I can put this into reverse. Oh, and it's saying that the frunk is unlatched still, because it is. So I'm going to say ignore and continue to drive. And so now Let's see. Oh, electrical system backup power is unavailable. So that's interesting. Condition detected with a vehicle controller. So it's noticing anomalies here. And okay, there we go. So I was just able to put this car into drive. And now it's saying the speed limit is limited to 15 miles an hour, but at least we can drive this car for a distance to get to emergency assistance. So that's just briefly how to use this jump pack in this particular situation.
There he goes, he's taken off and he's gonna go get that low voltage battery replaced right away.
Here's another use case for the jump pack functionality on here. I have put on the alligator clamps that are plugged into this port here on the side of the unit. And what we have going on here
is we have this 12 volt battery that is discharged, and it looks like there's some corrosion. It may not be in optimal condition. This is not mine, but I'm helping somebody else out, and I thought I'd just demonstrate the jumping functionality. If I try to start it, this is how dead the battery is. And you can hear it kind of winding down. The battery is almost dead. So I'm going to put the jump pack on it, just there to the side, because obviously I can't put it here. This spins around, and it's connected, of course, to the positive, negative terminals of the battery, and let's try it out. There we go.
I think it's a great idea to have a device like this in your car, and that's whether or not it's a gas car or electric car, it doesn't matter. This is actually useful for both types of cars, which is interesting. Obviously, both have tires, and so this can be an air pump in an emergency situation. But also, as I illustrated for Teslas, you can, or other electric vehicles, they have a low voltage system that this can supplement if you have a low voltage battery problem. And then this can also be used to jumpstart full-size cars, or as I showed, a lawnmower. And so this is a very useful to have in your car as kind of an emergency tool. So I hope this was helpful, and I will leave a link in the description below to this pump. And with that, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.